The Chicago Bulls got themselves a win last night versus the Toronto Raptors. But with all things considered, I have to let you guys know that the Chicago Bulls should really make Coby White their focal point for a retool. Y'all know we're going to talk about it, break it down. But you know, you got to hear the music first.
Cognac. Gang.
Shy Boys Podcast with the Cognac Boys. I'm Cognac Boy Bobby, and I'm holding it down on today's daily episode for Shy Boys Podcast. If you're tuning in with me today, make sure you hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell as well. But hey, yesterday, the Chicago Bulls got a victory over the Toronto Raptors. We seen that victory pretty much come from three main guys. And you know, you had some contributors in there, but I got to show love to the guys that really put in that work and really had fantastic games to push the Chicago Bulls to win. That's Nikola Vucevic, DeMar DeRozan, and Coby White. But I really want to touch on Coby White. I really do. I believe that Coby White should be the focal point for the Chicago Bulls retool. For me personally, I think it's time for the Chicago Bulls to absolutely pick a direction. We've seen what the big three is. We kind of know what the ceiling is, and that's a first-round exit, in my opinion. We've seen that with one of them missing, the team looks a lot better. With all of them on the court, it looks a bit shaky. I gotta give them a little kudos for at least going out there and trying, though, right? Yeah, I'll give them that. But at the same time, that offense is still not moving the way that I feel like it was moving when Zach LaVine was out. And that's not saying that Zach LaVine should be the only one that's gone. But we do have to consider that he did request a trade. We do have to consider that the front office might be interested in a trade. So I'm looking at all that in its totality and pretty much saying, look, the front office, they don't want to go into a full rebuild, but you got to look at your big three on who you thought was going to be a core to push the Chicago Bulls to playoff contention and hopefully start to add on to that to where you can be in championship contention. But it just simply hasn't worked. We still got questions about DeMar DeRozan's contract. I know earlier, reportedly, early in the season, around November, you know, late November, early December, that the Bulls in Chicago, the Chicago Bulls and DeMar DeRozan, they wasn't really on the same page when it came to an extension or, you know, remaining with the team. So that's something that you absolutely have to look at heading closer and closer to the trade deadline. Because if you let DeMar DeRozan walk away for nothing, you're going to look at the Bulls front office a little bit more shaky, because the last two trade deadlines, we see minimal movement from the front office. In that year one when Lonzo Ball got hurt, when all these guys was together, we seen the Chicago Bulls do nothing at the trade deadline to replace a Lonzo Ball. Instead, they elected to pick up a Tristan Thompson in the buyout market. Then the season after that, still struggling. The Chicago Bulls were struggling bad. Got closer to the trade deadline. Bulls did nothing. They got Patrick Beverley in the buyout market. So I would say right now it's in favor that the Chicago Bulls front office don't do much. At least that's what we can believe in. They don't do much, and they look to pick up somebody in the buyout market. But that's not the mentality I believe that the front office should have. I believe that right now, if you want to continue to improve in ways, you have to do something to move. Right now, I feel like the Chicago Bulls, we are practicing insanity, doing the same thing, expecting different results, but ain't nothing changing. That's just what it really is. This team, I believe, with the big core, with the big three, or what we like to call them, whatever, the mid three, however you like to, you know, relate to them or whatever you like to call them, they just haven't been good enough, man. They just haven't been good enough, and it's just a style of play that you know is present with the Chicago Bulls, but it's not going to happen because this big three, they all have a weird mixture of potion. for a lack of a better phrase or a word that I could use. It's a weird mixture of potion to where you believe, you believe that these guys can work, but it's just not working. Because if you look at Nikola Vucevic, you say this is a big who can work inside, outside, shoot the three. Then you got Zach LaVine, who's a three-level scorer. Then you got DeMar DeRozan, who this season is shooting a little bit from that third level from the perimeter. But he's still mostly a mid-range guy and a ball-dominant player. So it's a little bit of a weird mixture. You know what I'm saying? Like if you go to the bar and you order some weird mixture, maybe a trash can. I don't know if y'all ever had that drink or that beverage, but a trash can is a mixture of a lot of things. When you think about it, it might taste decent or it might taste good in some people's mouth. Ooh, that's a pause. But at the end of the day, you know, it's just a mixture of stuff. You're like, man, it's going to get me lit, but it might not make me feel good the following morning. Just, to, you know, so we have to look at all that and what it actually means. But we do know. The front office, they're not interested in the rebuild. They want win-now players. So my thing and my proposal is try to add win-now players that support Coby White and what the hell he's been doing. You already got good supporting members, but if you want to go ahead and move other guys out the way so you can elevate others, you got to eventually either say we're doing away with Zach, we're doing away with DeMar, and I don't know where the Chicago Bulls stand and how they feel about Nikola Vucevic, but I do know Nikola Vucevic, he's a guy who's going to be productive, but he has his challenges with younger, bigger, or more athletic bigs who have a more dominant presence in the paint. Nikola Vucevic has his challenges. Sometimes he gets the best of them, but a lot of times those guys get the best of him. So the focus for the retool should be around Coby White. Coby White has shown that he could be a driving force for this retool team. And one thing I like to look at, or that I've been looking at lately, is that the Chicago Bulls were in the same boat as the Raptors and the Hawks, or are still in the same boat as the Hawks. The Raptors eventually made their decision to say, hey, this isn't working. We have a young budding player who we believe could be something, maybe all-star caliber player, you know, with consistent all-star appearances and Scottie Barnes. And we're going to do away with this thing because it has ran its course. The only thing that we've seen last season with our organization, that's the Toronto Raptors, that is that we can make the play-in and maybe make the first round and then get bounced. That's kind of the same thing where we at with the Chicago Bulls. But see, the Toronto Raptors made their decision. They said Scottie Barnes is going to be our focal point. We're going to get new players in here. We're going to recoup on assets, and we're going to try to piece together a small rebuild. I don't think they went completely rebuild, but they added things on by getting rid of OG Anunoby, by getting rid of Pascal Siakam and players like that. So you want to see the Chicago Bulls try to make a decision on where they should be going. Because if you continue to run this thing, you will be and will remain in the same boat as the Atlanta Hawks, a team with a lot of promise, with a lot of good names on the team, but the results do not add up at the end of the season. You know what I'm saying? Because whatever reason, during the regular season, these guys just seem like they don't mesh. And the Hawks are still in there in that boat with the Chicago Bulls. The Raptors, they just got off the boat, found themselves a new boat, and decided we're going to veer off to the left. We're going to veer off to the left, and we're going to just ride the wave and see where this thing leads us. And I believe that's what the Chicago Bulls need to do. I don't know. Again, I don't know if that decision is best if you decide that we're going to move everybody. And what I mean everybody, I mean Vooch, DeMar, and Zach. Or you can look at the situation to say, look, we could just get rid of one of these guys, get a guy, another young player in here, maybe a proven player who can come in, fill the void, and we can just kind of mesh this thing a little differently with what we have. And the reason I want Coby White to be the driving force is simply because he can do just about anything. He still has his ways to grow, but he has shown that he's smart with the basketball. And he take care of the basketball. He can take care of the basketball in clutch moments. He can do certain things that a lot of players on the Bulls can't do right now. Can we see other guys elevate themselves? Absolutely. But right now, Coby White is the best young player on the Chicago Bulls. This guy has been consistently better and much, much better, you know, we would say after November, you know what I'm saying? He started to really getting it going. That back end of November to where Coby White started to get things done. So he should be that focal point because everything that he can do, he's being active on the defensive side. He's taking care of the basketball offensively. He's able to get to the basket in closing moments of the game at will, draw fouls, has a nice jumper from the three-point line to where it stretches and spaces out a defense and allows the offense to be able to do whatever they need to do. And I think that Coby White is fitting into that new point guard to where a lot of people like to refer to traditional point guards. That phase is kind of – that whole thing is kind of – it's phasing out. Let's keep it a buck. It's phasing out of that old traditional point guard. Right now, you need more of a hybrid, a guy that can take care of the basketball, but a guy that can take care of the basketball, a guy that can set up your offense, but also has the capability of torching other teams off the pick and roll, getting downhill, spacing the floor, and shooting a three-point ball. And Coby White does all of that on top of the defense that he's able to bring each and every night. So I believe if you don't want to rebuild, you make Coby White the focal point in your retool. He's just that good. I believe Coby White, if you look at him and Scotty Barnes, they're right there in the same tier. There will be some people that's, you know what I'm saying, put Scotty Barnes above Coby White, and that's fine. That's your choice. I'm going to say, for my sake of my Chicago Bulls, who I support, Coby White for this team should be the focal point and move the Bulls on to new and better things. That's what it comes down to for me. So we got to look at that, got to be able to come to terms and say, hey, this retool is exactly what we need. But the focal point of the retool to get this old monkey off our back, to get this stank out of the room, to move the elephant out of the room, which will be very, very hard with that big ass elephant. You got to go with somebody who is capable of being a 20-plus point scorer per game on the team, who has youth, who has grown, who has earned his opportunity, and that guy is Coby White. That's it for me today, ladies and gentlemen. Let me know your thoughts below. I believe that Coby White should be the focal point for the Chicago Bulls retool because the Bulls need to pick a direction. This thing has ran its course. I believe there's nothing else you can absolutely do. I mean, you can try, but the big three just don't work anymore. That's what it comes down to for me. But that's it, ladies and gentlemen. If you tuned in with me, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell. Thanks for tuning in to another episode of Shy Bulls Podcast. I'm Bobby. I'm going to catch y'all on the next one for sure. Cognac.